Musical Collective, Indian Jam Project, is a fusion platform started by the young composer and producer Tushar Lal, wherein a variety of artists come to produce the Indian interpretation of Western music.
In the last 3 years, they've made over 13 music videos, have garnered over 12 million views on their YouTube channel, and have bowled us over by the beautiful music that they create. In an attempt to knit the contrasting tones of Indian instruments into the script of Western music, they attempt to revive the fallen essence of our traditions. Today we have with us the brains behind the collective, the ingenious Tushar Lal. Alongside Tushar, we have with us the three very integral members of the Indian Jam Project, the well-renowned and very learned sitarist, Shri Prasad Rahane, the well-renowned percussionist, Shri Rupak Dhamankar, and the flute maestro, Shri Abdut Farke. The gnoTalks team is proud to have the Indian Jam Project with us here today.
So, let's start with the basic questions. When and what inspired you to start the Indian Jam Project?
I've always thought Indian instruments are very emotionally evocative. And I'm the only person between the four of us who's not Indian classical. So, my background is completely Western. And when I was in college, I was around a lot of Indian classical people. So, I just thought like maybe incorporate Indian instruments into playing some of the Hollywood scores. If you talk about playability, Hollywood scores are really good. And yeah, so that's pretty much it. So we started with this tiny experiment in my room where we played the Game of Thrones theme using a tabla and a flute. And I think because Indian Jam Project was the first mover, like no one else was doing this before us. So it went viral and then we just continued and it carried on.
Okay, sir. So, the Indian Jam Project happens to be a very apt name for the kind of work that you do. How did you coin it?
It's not the best name. Actually, we got stuck with it. We worked on a Sherlock theme, the BBC Sherlock theme, and the original composer of the theme, he's an Emmy Award winner, his name is Michael Price. So, he tweeted it, and the video was called Indian Jam on BBC Sherlock theme, and he thought that Indian Jam is the name of the band, and this isn't exactly a band, it's more like a collective where musicians just come together and do something good. So he started calling it Indian Jam Band, and because he's such a famous person, I think a lot of people retweeted calling it Indian Jam Band, which I did not like at all. Indian, so I just thought like maybe like switch the word band with project and this will be way better. So yeah, Indian Jam Project. We could have come up with some better names, maybe some like heavy Sanskrit word, but yeah, we're stuck with Indian Jam Project and now we like it. Now we love it. We associate to it. It's more like home, so it's okay.
Sir, and you guys have stated very often that you are a collaboration and not a band. So what are the challenges that you have faced as a collaboration and how do you plan to overcome it?
I think all of us should answer this question. Okay, I can answer from my perspective. So I usually arrange the parts and in some cases like I compose the parts. Okay. So especially if I'm writing parts for other instruments, I'll write it from my perspective. So I'll see a piano in front of me, I'll be like, okay, my hands are going anywhere, right, and I'll just write them. But if it's a sitar, it's very hard to incorporate the same tune on a sitar because your hands are like literally stretched out like that.
Right.
So I mean, and also as musicians, they add so much. So, my Hindi is mashallah, man. Why did I try? My perspective ends there. Okay. And that's where I stop. But then again, these guys add a lot as musicians while they are playing it. And I stay completely out of percussions. That's something I don't interfere. Okay. So like, he would usually like think of everything himself. And yeah, and even while playing, like they would do these really tiny articulations and these harkats which sound very good and which add a lot of character and flavor to whatever the piece is.
Okay, so it's all kind of random, like you come up with like different...
No, so like I make the arrangement and I compose some of the parts.
Okay.
And basically I would compose notes, so I would tell them like, okay, these are the notes I want and you play this and around this you can do something.
Right.
So, unless it's a solo, like for example, like we did Requiem for a Dream and he played a solo in it. So I would not like instruct him in any way because if he's playing a solo, he's probably the best person to know what he can do with his instrument. So,
and for you guys, How has working in the Indian Jam project been different from the other projects you have worked on? So, like, we'll start off with you.
Okay, so what I basically work with is more of Bollywood.
Okay.
With music directors, with singers. So, वहाँ पे कैसे होता है कि वहाँ पे fix part बजाने हैं या फिर वहाँ पे what we call is bars in musical terms.
Right.
उसमें बजाना होता है. वो chord chart follow करके बजाना होता है.
Okay.
But यहाँ पे as the name says Indian Jam Project, so we get to play whatever we feel like. So yeah, we just take the feel out of it and we play. So we enjoy more. Like we get the freedom of playing whatever.
Yeah.
You want to play.
So you feel the music and you
yes,
just play.
Exactly.
Oh, okay. Okay. Like no one's stopping them
exactly.
If they're like doing something extra, because extra is always good. Mm-hmm. Even if your parts are like written, if you're adding something extra to it which makes it sound beautiful,
right.
Like why not do it? So that creative freedom is very important, and especially if like someone's as talented as them who can actually mm-hmm. utilize this ability
yeah.
and like produce something very beautiful out of it.
Right.
So why not?
And Rupak sir.
Yeah, so for me, actually, like playing Hollywood scores, so basically, unme aap dekhoge ki bahut heavy rhythm hota hai, like you know, all timpanis and everything,
yeah.
and uske exact opposite, it's tabla, it's only tabla.
Yeah.
So that is the most difficult task, like you know, ki aapke samne ek bahut bada pahad hai, and you're just a tiny person,
okay.
you have to replicate the same sound.
Okay.
From just one instrument
okay.
and probably cymbals and all. And yeah, this is one of a kind like project which I'm playing basically. So it's very difficult and it's very interesting. Like, you know, to play on an Hollywood score, that too tabla.
Right.
The
yeah.
thought, it doesn't match
right.
actually.
Yeah.
But
right.
he has like done it very beautifully with all like all the members and all. And yeah, so it's literally really difficult, but I hope like we do it.
Okay.
And you do it
yeah.
really well.
Yeah.
When
yeah.
I'm pretty sure when he
yeah.
plays, he becomes the pahad, and
exactly.
the Hollywood score becomes
exactly.
like the tiny man.
Exactly, exactly.
So,
for me, as a sitarist, sitar is not made for that kind of music. और ये जो scores है, कि यहाँ से वहाँ छलांग लगाना और तो मेरे लिए शुरुआत में काफी मुश्किल रहा कि ये सब adapt करना और मैं बहुत कुछ सीखा है इसमें और ट्राई करते हैं और साथ में मजा आता है
ग्रो करते हैं इट्स आल्सो लाइक इट्स इफ इट्स अ चैलेंज फॉर हिम देन आफ्टर ही इज डन इट्स अ चैलेंज फॉर मी एंड मे बी आई विल थिंक दैट ओके मे बी नेक्स्ट टाइम आई विल डू समथिंग व्हिच इज मोर डिस्पोज्ड टुवर्ड्स अ सितार यू नो लाइक ट्राई टू थिंक लाइक अ सितार सो आई विल फील हॉरिबली बट लाइक ही हेल्प्स मी सो बोथ ऑफ अस इट्स अ वेरी सिम्बायोटिक थिंग या सो वी आर हेल्पिंग ईच अदर आउट सो दैट्स अनदर ब्यूटीफुल थिंग अबाउट दिस
थैंक यू सो मच
And that is what makes it so, you know, unique and beautiful.
Yeah. It definitely adds something to it.
Okay. So, sir, you started off in music at a very early age. When exactly did you realize that you wanted to pursue a career in music? And how did you train yourself for it?
No, I think it's the same with all of us. I don't know
yeah.
if I should talk for everyone else, but
okay.
we did not really have a choice. Like, I never...
Okay.
I know, and it's, I'm not saying like our parents, especially my entire family is filled with bureaucrats, so I should
okay.
like be entirely against what I'm doing right now, but it never was a choice for me, so I never thought ki haan music hai ki padhai hai, so it was always music,
okay.
so like you come back to music no matter what you do,
right,
so the choice didn't exist
okay.
in the first place, so I mean, how will I choose a career path
okay.
or like
that
do whatever.
Actually brings us to the next question, that in the conventional Indian society and the family that we all grow up in,
mm.
when you make decisions like this, like choosing music as the means to your end, you face a lot of resistance.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
given
yes.
the initial risk of your unique idea,
yeah.
How difficult you'd say your journey has been and what kept you going despite all that?
I mean, it's just something which is very different, and fusion as a genre gives you a lot of... You have a lot to learn,
yeah.
and it literally feeds you in a lot of way. So as a musician, you keep growing like thirsty and hungry for that.
Right.
So carrying on with it is not really, I can't
make carrying on sound like ki are matlab chal rahe hain. No, it's yeah, like we have a lot of fun, like we are definitely enjoying this. And families, I had a little hard time explaining my fam what I'm doing and blah blah blah. And I think it's after a year and a half when Indian Jam project got famous, I think some guy sent some links to my father that is this your son. So I was doing something, and inside my house people still didn't have any clue that like maybe they just knew that he's going out, he's doing shows and he's shooting videos. So it's after they saw that, and then they were actually like, my parents are not very uptight, they were a little supportive about this, like I had to make them understand. But after that they're
proud of you.
Yeah, and I think, I mean, these guys are a little fortunate if you talk about that, because they have music in their families. Prasad ji, I think he's a solid.
That must have been the same way.
Yeah, so something. You'll get different story from, like, I think you should ask them.
For me, I'm the fourth generation in my family.
So you had
nobody,
to carry on.
Yeah, but nobody pursued it as a full time thing. Okay. So I had to make a decision to go ahead and do it. But utna challenges support wise nahi hua ki family se support tha, whatever you are doing is like, we support you. But independently music karna itself is a like a task.
Yeah.
Like if you are not doing anything else apart from music for earning point of view. Yeah. So like matlab hamare society ke log to pehle poochte hi acha. Like this question everybody gets a lot who are doing the independent music ki acha music karte ho lekin kamane ke liye kya karte ho.
Exactly. Yeah. Exactly. Yeah. The same thing.
So I never take it. Answering this question in an engineering college where everybody is there because I don't know, just because
their family said. They'll never take it seriously. They'll be like, "Haan, matlab gaane bajane shauk ke liye theek hai,
music kare ya acha theek hai, lekin kamane ke liye
kya karte ho?"
But it takes a time, because aisa agar hota ki music mein jao career ban gaya to sab log aa jate hain. So it takes a journey, and it's a little hard journey, but maza aata hai. Like thode din ke baad maza aata hai.
Passion is everything.
Yeah. You have to be focused. You don't have to lose your mind, like come what may.
Yeah. So I had a time like a very tough time.
Okay.
Being from a musical family, I'm the second generation.
Okay.
My dad is a tabla player, so more than me, he faced a lot of problems. So like, हमारे family में कोई उनके अलावा कोई music पे था नहीं. So and he was married to a like lady who doesn't know anything about music.
Okay.
Or neither her family knows about anything about music. So hamesha, you know, there used to be fights ki yaar kya karega ye
exactly
tabla baja ke, because ek hai, like, you know, every common family is like, ye like as a hobby theek hai, par banna aapko like pehle ek, I'll tell you, 90s mein every parent used to say, "Mera beta doctor ya engineer banega."
Exactly.
This is the common like dialogue.
Beyond 90s.
Beyond 90s. Like, pehle
80% senior.
Mera beta engineer nahi to doctor banega. But my dad was like, "No." My mom is a doctor. She was like, "Nahi." Like, she was like, "Nahi." Mera beta doctor, like doctor. He would be a doctor. But yeah, my dad fought like, "Ki nahi." He has to be a musician. He has, like, unhone gamble khela ki, like, he saw a spark, like he can play. Aisa blindly, he didn't push me into music, but yeah, he told me ki, like, he is good, like, you should learn, you should go ahead. And then finally, after, like, you can say about, like, when I became like around 20, and when my mom saw me like performing like here and there, that time, like, the whole family were like, "Chalo, nahi." Like,
they have to see something concrete.
Yeah.
And even they are right. Even they are right. Like, you know, they will always look for the best for your child.
The intention is always good, sir.
Yeah. You have to believe in yourself that
exactly.
I will be there.
And
I
you have
need
to work
some
that
time.
Hard.
Yeah, you need to have the vision.
Because other people are not seeing it.
Yeah.
Right.
Exactly. Point
of view. So
I mean, the part of doing your riyas and getting up to a level, that's the hardest time. Like, you know, kyunki aap sirf ghar pe baith ke baja rahe ho. बाहर कहीं पे नहीं बजा रहे. इनफैक्ट क्लासिकल म्यूजिक में हम तीनों, एज ही सेड, हम क्लासिकल फैमिली से यूजुअली बिलोंग करते हैं. सो क्लासिकल गुरुज विल ऑलवेज टेल यू, आपको जब तक मैं कहूँ तब तक आपको बाहर परफॉर्म नहीं करना है. ये दिस इज लाइक द फर्स्ट
कंडीशन.
लाइक यू डोंट हैव टू परफॉर्म एनीवेयर आउटसाइड लाइक अनलेस बिकॉज एक तैयारी होती है म्यूजिशियन की. लाइक यू नो ये गलत कहीं पे नहीं बजाना चाहिए या इट शुडंट साउंड किडिश.
एक्चुअली आई विल से कि अगर आप इंजीनियर कॉलेज में इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज में हो या फिर डॉक्टरी MBBS कर रहे हो तो 3-5 साल में आपके पास एक डिग्री आ जाती है. आप इंजीनियर बनते हो, लॉयर बनते हो, डॉक्टर बनते हो, लेकिन म्यूजिशियन आप कभी नहीं बन पाते. You have to practice, practice and practice till your last
breath.
और फॉर मी जब मैं 10th में था मेरे फैमिली में कोई म्यूजिशियन नहीं है. माय फादर वाज अ न्यूज़पेपर सेलर एंड माय मदर वाज नर्स. तो जब मैं 10th में था तो मुझे बहुत अच्छा लगता था बजाना. मैं बचपन से ही मतलब सीखने लगा था जब 4th या 5th standard में था. तो तब मैं सिर्फ रियाज करता था और आई डोंट इवन केयर कि मेरे माँ बाप को कितना परेशानी हो रही है कि वो रो लिटरली वो रोते थे कि अरे ये फेल हो जाएगा.
पढ़ाई की जगह पे म्यूजिक कर रहा
लेकिन मैं
हमारे घर पे
और मैं रियाज करता था. मेरे सामने बैठ के वो रोते थे और मैं रियाज करता था और वो बोलते थे अरे चलो 11 बजने को है अभी पेपर को जाना है 10th. तो मैं ऐसे ठीक है चलो जाते हैं. तो अगर if you love your instrument,
yeah,
so nothing is hard.
That is how driven you all were.
अभी हम देखते हैं कि हमने ऐसे किया था उस टाइम, तो अभी हम लोगों को लगता है कि हाँ ये हार्ड था.
वो हाँ, ऑफ तो कर रहे हैं.
Yeah, exactly. It's paying off.
It's very inspiring us, inspiring for us to see the passion for music that you guys have.
I mean, but again, this is also a job. So you know, for us, it's not so, it's not so extraordinary. I mean.
Yeah.
Like you know, like how you study your subjects,
right?
Yeah,
so
yeah,
we
exactly.
study, like they study the instruments, I study composition. So I mean,
right.
It's more like what we are doing. You know, there's nothing fascinating about it. Oh my God, musician. It's all very basic.
And talking about passion, sir, you said that you quoted once that not everyone who's pursuing a dream is already there. So where does the Indian Jam project stand in the process?
Indian Jam project, I don't have any goal-oriented thinking when it comes to Indian Jam project.
Okay.
So it's basically Indian Jam project is a collaborative platform where Indian classical musicians come together to show how diverse Indian instruments can be.
Right.
So it is a lot about the musicians who are playing, but most importantly, it's about depicting their instrument in a light which acts like a bridge between someone who's not able to understand an Indian classical instrument.
Okay.
Right.
So you
right.
know, so like if you talk about a sitar
like,
or a sarangi, you know, like people, it's so sad, but you know, people have this predisposed notion that, arey, this might be boring. Ek ghante ka sitar concert hai. Hum log to classical jante bhi nahi, to kya karega? But if they see a sitar playing Pirates of the Caribbean, they'll be like,
yeah,
I want to learn this
yeah.
instrument.
Exactly.
It sounds so good.
Yeah.
So no, it's all about acting like a bridge between the people who can't understand this realm of music.
Okay.
Right.
Right.
Yeah, so Indian Jam project is definitely on its way. I mean, as
you
I
don't
told
have
you,
a goal to reach, you're just going.
You're going with the flow.
See, okay, this is a controversial thing to say, but
okay.
you can never trust the audience, man.
Exactly.
I mean,
yeah,
you know, I've been
true.
working, I've been working my ass off on Indian Jam project for a year and a half, 2 years.
Yeah.
And then this girl.
Okay.
Her name is Dinjak Pooja.
Okay. Yeah.
She released
okay.
a video,
okay.
which hit 25 million.
Okay.
And my entire work over the span of 2 years
yes.
put together is 12 million.
Yes.
I'm not half as good as her in terms of views. So I've honestly stopped thinking like that altogether. Like, you know, I don't think in terms of like, oh, we have. Yeah. As long as we are, you know, like, as long as whatever purpose we serve,
right.
we are catering to that. You know, so as long as someone is seeing something like James Bond
okay.
and
yeah.
going like, "Arey, like how is a sitar playing that?" and then getting fascinated by that and trying to learn a sitar, so that's where
right.
like Indian Jam project succeeds.
Okay.
So there is no goal in terms of getting big on YouTube or something like that. Not that I mind. I mean,
okay.
it feels good to have numbers, but
exactly.
then again,
you
it can't rely
you.
On that.
As like you pointed out, you take the quality more over the quantity. The quality of surprised that your art form inspires in people. You take that quality over the quality. So
quality,
that,
yeah.
That
quality.
Brings me to a particular question. You know, let's just say people even appreciate the art, but then when you are working on a piece, the brainstorming, the emotions and the hard work, it takes a lot to get even a tiny piece perfect. And even when people are liking your videos and they're sharing it, but they are failing to grasp those little intricate details. So does that sort of disappoint you or take away from your satisfaction as an artist?
Not at all. I think
so the thing is, ye jo minor jo ye cheeze hai,
yes,
I believe wo musicians ko zyada samajh mein aayegi rather than layman. So if musicians can catch that thing and appreciate, we'll be very happy.
And that is where your satisfaction.
Musicians care a lot about what other musicians think of them.
Yeah.
Exactly. This is right. Like the biggest truth anyone's gonna tell you. Like we might come off like, oh, I don't care about like what people think.
Like,
no, it's not true. We give a lot of
okay.
can't use that word. We care a lot about other fellow musicians respecting us. I mean, that is definitely very, very important.
So it's just critical like acclaim over publicity. Popularity
comes with mass. I mean, you know, like if you're doing something like Harry Potter, it's a cult movie, so a lot of people will be driven to that video. But you know, there are these, if you've heard the sarangi in Harry Potter, there are Sandeep Mishra, he's played the sarangi, and there are these really tiny details he's put in, and they're just
really
beautiful. So that a musician will catch.
Okay.
If you've heard James Bond, like the stuff he's done some crazy articulations with sitar.
Yeah.
So if you listen to those harkats, a musician will be like, oh my god, this guy is badass.
Okay.
You know, and that matters a lot. Even if that's just like one guy, it matters a lot to us.
Okay.
I think you don't have to understand that. You have to feel that.
Okay.
And I think subconsciously it's already adding. Like, you know, you're not listening to it on purpose, but subconsciously it stays inside your head.
You don't have to listen with your brain.
Yeah, exactly.
It adds to the feel automatically.
Yeah.
It does.
Okay. So, sir, moving on, you mentioned this once somewhere that...
How are you all like quoting me from everywhere? Okay, cool. Yeah, tell me.
So, can I?
Yeah, please. Okay. Please, I'm so sorry.
So, you mentioned it somewhere that you've played at places and done things that you're not proud of. So, as an artist, how can a display of your art make you feel ashamed or embarrassed?
Not ashamed, but you feel that your music deserves a better place. This is a better place.
Yeah,
this is
a
better place.
That's
so
every
like,
honor for us.
I don't. I think the first gig we did was someone's marriage ceremony, and this was when. I'm talking about the first video, and the first video came out, and then we
after
got...
After the first video?
Yeah. So, right after that, and we got this, and you know, like, even if you're getting something like 10, 15 grand, you get very excited, that, oh my god, I'm going to get money, so chalo, karte hain.
That's the first thing.
And you know, and we kept playing our music, and no one was really paying attention to whatever we were doing. And then there are places like this, where you get like this massive response.
Okay.
So, I think as an artist, this is something which is very, very important. You have to split your soul into two halves.
Exactly.
One which is going to take care of your bread and butter.
Yeah.
And the other which is for your own self-contentment and your own satisfaction.
So
this is our like satisfaction bit.
Okay.
You know, because even a lot of things we were doing on stage, we didn't really decide. You know, and it's just random improvisation. And like we can tell that the crowd's appreciating that.
Yeah, actually we appreciated that how can a thing so random be so beautiful?
Yeah,
right.
So I mean, yeah, it's more about that, but at times, like I'm pretty sure these guys do jingles and they record for, I've done a jingle for a Viagra pill because I was getting paid for it. I'm not going to name the production house or the
pill. Okay, now we get it.
But
we
I mean, it's just, it's just like you have to take care of your bread and butter. I mean,
so
this is something you should understand as a musician. You can't be a purist about it. And be like, no,
so both
like
the halves go hand.
You can't, if you have to survive in a city like Bombay, you can't be like that.
So
you have to work everywhere.
So is it like a compromise that you do sometimes?
Not a compromise, it's
the
a necessity.
Is, image ke liye agar, if you are thinking of that point, it matters what you publish of yourself. Agar aap har ek cheez kar rahe ho, wo logon ko bata rahe ho ki, oh, I did this, I did that. So it will definitely affect your image. Jo important cheez hai, jisme, if we publish that, so it's good. जो बाकी काम करने हैं वो साइलेंट में करने
बट आई थिंक एज अ म्यूजिशियन लाइक आफ्टर गेटिंग टू अ लेवल यू डेवलप एन लाइक यू नो इंटरेस्ट इन दिस फील्ड ओके लाइक सपोज फ्रॉम माय पर्सपेक्टिव आई वुड suggest like I would like to play for a fusion gig or a ghazal gig or a classical concert and even Bollywood like because yeah. that's my like the area
okay
so I guess everyone develops and like like you know your interest like I would love to play here I would love to play here yeah. so that is like one of the things like you know that is one of the things we like to do and like it's like in process like you know we learn about each and everything But at the end, like, we make choices, like, you know,
yeah.
we'll
you
go in this,
right.
we'll go
yeah.
in that, and
yeah.
we'll, like, make ourselves, like, publish, like, this only, okay.
Yeah. Yeah.
He's
the fine
a,
part,
like,
yeah.
you know, like,
it's
and
like
it's also, a, like, you know, it's your own choice as well. Like, there are many extraordinary players in this country, but they, you never know their names. It's just their choice, because I would only play a classical concert. It's their mentality. Like,
okay.
you know, there are some
okay.
musicians,
only
I would only do this or
yeah.
I will only go into teaching. That's it.
Okay.
It's their choice.
So they like, don't get the fame, but they are really
Yeah,
talented.
And they are happy with that.
Okay, they are
like,
happy.
Yeah. Some of
they
the
don't
gurus
want to compromise their.
Yeah.
It's their work that matters to them,
mm-hmm.
not the popularity.
What they do is matters to them.
It's a very subjective thing.
Yeah.
It's a very subjective
yeah.
thing.
Right.
And some people are doing everything and they're not less proud about it. Like, they flaunt that. Oh, I'm
okay.
doing bhajan and Bollywood and like everything
yeah.
there and everything.
Yeah,
so I mean,
right.
it's a very subjective thing.
Right.
Okay, so
apart from music, what are the things that you guys generally bond over as friends?
Khana.
As we were doing right now.
Yeah, we witnessed that.
Yeah. Like every
like
musician is a foodie.
Yeah, yeah, yeah that is
they,
true.
Yeah,
that is
every
true.
Musician has to be foodie.
But the converse of it is never true.
And
yeah.
really, really, really bad jokes.
Yeah.
Like, you know, jokes
really.
Like you'll hear and you'll be like, oh my god, get rid of this guy.
Yeah.
You know, very bad jokes.
Very
like
bad.
Absolutely bad dad jokes, you know, like the classic dad jokes. Yeah.
But you guys would bond over that.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
We'll be like, are kya
soch
raha tha, kyun aisa joke.
Okay. So, sir, moving on to your videos, apart from the art, what all goes into the production of your music videos?
I mean, we obviously record, then I kind of arrange it, and then there are like very talented people, my friends Toheen and Ritwik.
Yeah, yeah,
so
who direct the videos, right?
My god, okay.
So actually, you've mentioned
I don't have to
them.
Like
You've mentioned them in a very good light. Like you've
yeah.
always complimented. Like
where
that.
Are you reading? Okay, cool.
YouTube.
Okay, okay.
Yeah.
So yeah, these guys they obviously help all of us a lot, and they are very keen on shooting our videos and editing them,
yeah.
and doing it nicely. Because if it's a good video, if you put up a good video, that automatically tells people that you're also being a little professional about this. Like whatever we do, we can like hire a studio and shoot it. But we choose to like go to places and you know like shoot over mountains and like
yeah,
beaches because like we want people to know that we are a little serious about these things.
Okay. And how do you zero down to the next track you're gonna adapt?
I mean, two criteria. I look at the mass. I mean,
okay.
obviously,
okay.
I'm not gonna lie about this. Like the main reason behind doing Star Wars and Harry Potter and Pirates of the Caribbean was because I know these are cult films, so I'll get some traction out of it. But only scores. Like I wouldn't do something like I don't know. It's just not my thing. I wouldn't do something like Despacito. Or like, like
okay,
yeah, I know,
exactly,
I know. But that's
yeah.
for fun.
Okay.
I mean,
right.
I wouldn't like
yeah.
actually sit and produce it.
Okay.
Because Hollywood scores, the playability is a lot. So you know, like Despacito, it's just four chords and it's very catchy. But if it's Harry Potter, your hands are actually going everywhere. So everyone enjoys when you're. What was the question again?
How do you zero
down
to the
next
yeah and the second factor is how emotionally evocative it is so
okay.
like Interstellar it's not a mass or a cult film per se
it
but it's
okay.
very like you know it can like really hit you hard feels wise
okay
and yeah
okay sir so since you're here at gnoTalks and it comes with a motto to inspire and to be inspired So, what message would you give out to all those aspirants out there to inspire them? And this goes to all of you.
Yeah, we'll do this one. Like, whatever you're doing, don't stop. I think that's the most important thing. Like, if you have an aptitude for it, and if you're sensing that things are going good for you, so no matter what happens, you have to protect whatever you're aiming for. Because there are a lot of people who are just pessimistic and they're going to tell you stuff like, oh, you're not going to get through this. Even if like this is an engineering college and maybe like someone wants to drop out and be a graphic designer. There might be a lot of people who will be like, are you bewakoof hai kya, matlab kyun aisa karta. But if you have something, you need to protect it. So I mean, don't stop and like protect your thing till you get there.
Okay.
So
your messages.
So your message for that.
Yeah, actually it's a similar thing that whatever people say, just listen and leave it.
Okay.
Just focus on your work.
Focus on your work.
This is like a very toned down version of what I said. I should have just said that,
Exactly.
Like don't listen to people, like do whatever you want.
You should be focused and you should not get affected by like pehle stages mein aise hota hai for musicians ki people say ki are tu ye kya baja raha hai, wo dekh kya baja raha hai, wo acha baja raha hai.
Okay.
So you should not get affected by that. You should focus on your music. Whatever you learn, if I can enjoy, people will definitely enjoy.
That's
like the first thing which every musician is taught. Like you should enjoy your playing. That's the, if you have fun on stage, automatically the audience is going to enjoy.
I think that that goes for every profession. Like if you are enjoying your work, your not audience, clients maybe whatever, they'll be more happy about your work.
You have to just follow your hearts, that's it.
That's nice.
Short and sweet.
Short and
like
sweet.
All of us are answering and then he just like drops his statement like
actually,
a bomb.
Actually,
that just sums
it's
up.
Like the best thing
summary of
anyone's
everything.
Ever done.
We can make it like a title of the thing.
Exactly.
Now comes the trickiest part of the interview. We're going to have a short one-on-one rapid fire round. And you don't have to think it off.
Do you have like a gift hand? This is like coffee with coffee.
Where is the coffee?
Like, so we assure you one after the interview.
Yeah.
Okay,
yes,
cool.
Sir.
Yeah.
Surely.
You're going like
we'll
one by one?
Who's going to judge? We'll judge among ourselves. And then
we'll so all four of us are like participating?
Yes,
yes,
all four.
Cool.
One of us.
Cool.
I'm the one who, one of you guys who gives the best answers, like without thinking, they'll get the gift.
He's winning
already.
No,
sir. You guys can't be sure.
Yeah. Okay.
You guys have another chance, exactly.
So,
yeah.
First up, we have Rupert Dimakar, sir. Ready?
I'm like blank. That is what I'm supposed to be.
So, a lot of times people compare Indian and Western instruments like harmonium and piano. So, likewise with.
Let me just clear you. Harmonium is not Indian.
So now I'll give you the name of two Western instruments and whatever Indian instruments you relate them to, just like
yeah.
So the first one is cello.
Cello?
Yeah.
I've not heard.
Cello.
Yeah,
cello.
A bass guitar.
Oh shit.
Bass guitar.
Okay, yeah.
A bass guitar.
And harp?
Harp would be, like you're talking, there are two types of harp.
Okay.
Like there's one, a big harp and there is...
The big harp. Yeah.
I can say santur.
It's
the best.
Okay.
And the next question is, what is the one thing at the top of your bucket list right now?
Roaming the world. Like going out of music, but yeah.
Indian Jam Project World Tour.
He would be credited if you guys actually do that.
That's a promise, sir.
Okay. So the next up in the queue is you, Tushar, sir.
Yeah.
Okay. So the first question is, if you had a chance to meet any one of these music composers, who would you like to meet?
Hans Zimmer.
Okay.
It's very easy.
I didn't even mention.
Oh, okay. Oh, one of the. Oh, you were going to give me a list. Okay. I'm pretty sure Hans's name is in the list.
Yeah, exactly.
Like,
I'm
winning this so good.
Okay, you won it. Well, I was going to mention John Williams as well. I was going to mention John Williams and Hans Zimmer, side by side.
Still Hans Zimmer. Because he's more, apart from composition, he also gives a lot of attention to his sonicality. So, like, a lot of his movie, if you observe Blade Runner, which just came out, if you observe the score, through the entire score, he's only played 4 or 5 notes, but he's molded them sonically so good. Again, I'm these guys are like instrumentalists and they're like solid with the instruments. I do play an instrument, but I'm a composer at heart.
Okay.
So that really talks to me.
Okay, so the next question is, is there a special someone to whom you'd like to dedicate a video of yours, and which one would it be?
Yeah, you gave him the permission.
The manager Tanya is like.
Oh,
you're gonna answer. Special someone, okay.
Answer, you gotta be quick. You have to be quick.
I have to be quick.
Yeah, it's
okay,
rapid
this is
fire.
This is not an easy question.
It's rapid fire.
Special someone.
So please don't say your mother. Like.
Don't give him ideas. Yeah.
You just took my idea. Okay.
No.
Father. You can say father.
I'm not really dating someone. So
okay.
I mean, not as of yet.
Okay, an actress or whatever.
Actress.
Yeah.
That's very
amazing. Okay.
We're making it easy for you.
I just lost so bad.
Everything
was so good. Till that
you
composer
know.
Question, and then you like throw this at me. Okay.
He's just going through all the names.
No,
yeah.
No.
Exactly.
Okay.
Like, which one would be the best?
Yeah, yeah.
So how many have been there actually?
How many? I don't know, man.
But then coming
so
back,
we'll have
my
to
mom.
Okay.
My mom's my gal.
Answer which music video?
Tick one.
Gaya, re, I'm gone, I'm already like out of the league.
Cool one.
I would there is this Abida Parveen song. I can't remember it, but I'll like find it and dedicate it.
Okay.
That is such a good boy answer, na. Oh my mom.
Okay.
I'm just trying to like escape a lot of things.
Same
here.
So next up is Prasad sir. So the first question, what is your favorite pre-performance ritual?
Yeah, I like to play tabla in
green room. Before your performance, you play tabla?
Yeah.
He's a tabla player.
Okay, that's
yeah.
something,
yeah, even
that's
a
something
tabla
really
player.
New.
Yeah.
Okay.
Of course, Tatar, you
play tabla.
Play tabla. Wow,
cool.
Amazing.
So the next question, you cannot answer tabla, but just hear out the question. So if you could switch your current expertise in instruments with any instrument in the world, apart from sitar and tabla, what would it be?
Pakhavaj.
We'll definitely go and search about it.
Acha, haan.
Okay.
Okay,
and the last, but not the least, Abdul sir, your first question is, name another instrument that you're equally passionate about, as you're passionate about flute.
Another instrument? I like saxophone.
Oh, okay.
Oh, saxophone.
Yeah.
Flute and saxophone.
Cool.
I'm pretty sure you can play it all. You do play saxophone.
Yeah.
Okay.
I've tried my own.
And sir, the second question is more of a request than a question.
Okay.
Sir, I'll give you the name of a feeling, and whatever tune comes to your mind as soon as you hear the feeling, can you play that on the flute for us? A very small tune.
I'll try, because the only feeling right now all of us have is like hunger. It's
like the hunger.
Play something very sad.
I'm gonna give you a very different feeling.
Play something hungry.
The feeling is excited.
That is so unfair. He will win. we don't even stand a chance. Okay, cool.
We should talk actually.
Okay. To wrap this round up, we have a common question that goes to all four of you. Describe your gnoTalks experience only in one word.
What?
Describe your gnoTalks experience in one word.
Okay.
All.
One word.
Yeah,
okay.
Just one word. In this
whoever
word.
Answers it first.
Mesmerizing.
That's a
amber goes to me.
Okay, but
we
okay,
go,
go.
We'll go for all the answers.
Second best answer.
I want to say different, but I need a better word.
Different,
like different
noted.
And amazing.
Different is noted.
Okay, different.
Okay,
awesome.
Awesome.
Chalo. Answer.
Blissful.
Blissful. Again.
I think we have
again.
The winner now.
We have
the winner.
Yeah. I think it's
I told you pehle. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. No competition whatsoever.
Okay.
Arey, maine jaanboojh ke kyun nahi kiya.
Anyways, thank you so much, sir, for being a part of gnoTalks. It was pleasure for us to know you guys, and we wish you best of luck for your future endeavors.
Thank you.
Thank you so
thank
much.
You
so
much.
Thank you,
and Indian Jam World Tour. Best
surprise.
Coming, man. Why are you wishing us luck? You're coming. Yeah. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Yeah.
We want to thank you, all of you and your college.
Yeah, our pleasure, sir.
Our pleasure.
College is absolutely amazing. Honestly.
Okay.
Thank you. Very appreciative is what I wanted to say. The kids are very appreciative.
Good time.
Okay.
Yeah.
So thanks. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much.